So we are with Nick Springer. Nick, tell me about your life. Tell me what it was like before you went to camp and what happened and what happened after camp.
Absolutely. Well, I'm born and raised here in New York City, 1985. Lived in Brooklyn for 5 years. I am a third generation New Yorker. My grandmother was from Bogota, New Jersey. And my grandfather moved here to New York City when he was about 15, 16 years old from Rochester. So basically, and my dad was from here his entire life. So basically, you know, third generation here. And growing up, I loved the area. I loved everything about my life. I had a wonderful family. I had a wonderful grandparents. I was in a wonderful city. Spent a lot of time in Westchester when I was a kid. Grew up there. Playing hockey and camping and coming to work with my dad, who's a press agent on Broadway, and my grandfather, who used to be a press agent on, well, basically everything. And yeah, it was really, really a wonderful way to grow up here in the city. It was when I was 14 that my life took a bit of a drastic change when I attended a summer camp up in Western Mass. It was my third year attending. And it's something that I was really excited about because I loved it. I had a lot of friends there. We were in the woods, we were hiking, we were camping. What's not to love about it? After finishing a 3-day hike along the Appalachian Trail, got back to the camp on Thursday, August 5th. And I felt great. I felt fine. I was exhausted from the hike. It was probably about 15, 20 miles, but other than that, I felt fine. All of a sudden, around dinner time, start feeling a little ill. Asked to be excused from the mess hall, and in the course of 10 minutes, I went from feeling 100% to feeling possibly the worst I've ever felt. It was at that point that I went to the camp infirmary, where I was diagnosed with just your run-of-the-mill, average case of the flu. Nothing really extraordinary. Nothing really that should be treated in any sort of way other than just resting and keeping an eye on it. My symptoms were basically mild: vomiting, diarrhea, low-grade fever, stuff like that. The next morning, I actually was feeling a little better until about noon, when all of a sudden, I collapsed onto the floor and was rushed to the hospital. Once I got there, I was diagnosed with a rare form of bacterial meningitis known as meningococcemia. Within 19 hours, I went from a healthy, strong 14-year-old boy to being read my last rites, being induced into a coma with a 10% chance of survival, and I was basically on my deathbed from a disease that neither me nor anyone in my family had ever really heard of before.
And what happened once you woke up from the coma?
So I was in a coma for 2 months. That first week, I was very touch and go. I mean, like I said, I had less than 10% chance of survival, and my parents were really told by the doctors to prepare for the worst because they didn't want them to be, you know, overly shocked and surprised if, you know, they wanted to let them know, look, there's a good chance your son could pass away. I don't think any parent could ever be prepared for that, but they tried to at least warn them beforehand. Once I was stabilized and the disease was out of my system, about 3 weeks later, I went from Western Mass, from a hospital in Western Mass, still in a coma, to I was transferred here to New York City to the burn unit, where I had my legs amputated above the knee, my hands amputated at the forearm. And I had a tremendous amount of skin grafting done. I'd say about 35% of my body, at least. 20 surgeries over about a month.
Were you given the choice, or were you still in the coma?
I was still in the coma.
When you woke up from the coma to discover that your limbs were gone, what was your reaction?
You know, it would have been easy for a 14-year-old boy to say, well, this is the worst thing ever. It would have been easy for anybody to say this is the worst thing ever, and my life is over, and all that stuff. But I always, I mean, one of my earliest memories is I was probably out of the coma for a couple of days, and you don't wake up and you're conscious like, hey, how you doing? I've been in a coma for two months. It's a very slow process, a very confusing process for the person. So I don't remember the early stages, but one of the first memories I do have is talking to my dad about it. And I told him, I actually told him, no one ever told me, I told him, I said, I don't think I have any hands. And you know, he said, yeah, buddy, you don't, you lost them. But, and I said, well, I think I know about my legs too. And at this point, he's crying and saying, oh, yeah, sorry, you know, buddy, this happened, this is, it happened, and it's terrible. And he looked me, this is my father looking me dead in the eye when I'm 14, saying, you know what, everything's going to be okay. And I just remember thinking, all right. And, you know, the more we talked about it, the more I start to understand the fact that this is an extremely fatal disease. This is something that I probably shouldn't on paper have survived. But I was fortunate and I was lucky enough too.